I'm fine. Everything's cool. Just start the car.
You all right? You didn't get hurt?
Not at all.
That tree's dead, though.
Don't know much about handling automatic weapons, do you?
Well, I'm handling it, aren't I?
Well, I wish you'd put safety on that thing.
Ooh, you'd like that, wouldn't you?
I really would.
Oh, yeah, I bet.
Right there on...
Hey, put your damn hand down! Put it down. Don't try that trick on me. You think you're Mr. Smart? Well, you met Mr. Smarter. Honky muffa.
Hey, Donald. Would you please put the safety on? I mean, in case we stop suddenly or hit a bump or something.
Okay, Sonny. Yeah, right.
Now, would you point the gun in a safe direction?
Donald, for everyone's sake, will you do it?
Yeah, I am.
All right, now right in front of you.
Stop! Get in the hands! Get back in the hands! Good. That's fine. Okay. Back in safe direction.
Now, right in front of that hammer there is a lever on the left side of the gun. See? Push it up. It's right thumb.
Great. Now what?
Well, now the gun's on safe.
Excuse me, officer.
Have a seat.
We have a man...
Have a seat, okay?
Okay. We'll just have to wait a little bit.
Come on.
Listen, he's busy, and I hate to put you...
Detective, I've just been accosted.
Pardon me, ma'am, but we were here first.
I was accosted.
In this century?
Let the lady talk, will you? Everybody calm down, okay? Now, what's your complaint, ma'am?
I was on my way home from my friend Alice's apartment. I went over there to help her. She's making a sweater for her son. He's a big attorney in Denver.
Oh, cut the crap, Grandma. Get to the point.
Donald, stop that.
And as I passed the 7-Eleven, they started to shout nasty insults at me.
Oh, sir, I'm not talking pee-pee cock. I'm talking attempt to...
He's got a gun!
Yeah, well, I believe you got everybody's attention.
Drop the gun. Officer, I'm not the criminal. This man is the criminal. We just brought him in here.
That's true, officer. We don't want to make any trouble.
Put it on the desk, scumbag.
Get rid of the gun, Donald.
Officer, my name is Donald Quinnell. You know, the ironic thing is, this isn't even my...
Wait a minute. Aren't you the guy in the 5 o'clock news?
Yes!
Let him go.
You have violated my rights, not to mention my integrity. Oh, I think that's whiplash, attempted asphyxiation. That's a nice double lawsuit.
You know, you shouldn't go waving guns around like this.
Officer, that's not my gun. It's his gun.
It is. That's true, officer.
Well, sir, actually, the gun belonged to my father. See, he was killed carrying that weapon on Iwo Jima. He threw himself on a grenade. His commanding officer sent it to me. It's all I have to remember him by. Yes, sir.
While you're at that, why don't you tell him about the mule that General Lee gave your granny at Gettysburg?
Officer, this man is slicker than whale shit in an ice floe. I mean, whether you know or not, you're looking for this man. I mean, look at him. Doesn't he have a face like somebody in the rogue company in Deliverance? Come on now.
Oh, yeah? What'd he do?
Tell young Kojak what he did.
Well, actually, he's the gentleman who, who robbed the diner?
How could you not tell him that guy was the guy that killed Hoffa? That little fact just escaped you?
He could have just been talking. Let's get out of here.
I mean, it came to the big moment. I said, well, what'd he do? And then he said, well, he just robbed the diner. That's all. I'm like, zip, duda, nada. Like I tell the Hun, just conquered Europe. That's all. I mean, that guy wanted to kill you. He could have killed you, shoved you in a trash compactor. You end up as a doorstop for a guy named Vinny. You know, hey, how you doing?
We're still alive, aren't we? Anyway, the computer will discover who he is.
And in about 30 years, when he gets out of jail, he won't bear us any grudge. He'll go and kill the computer.
Oh, God. I had him out there. I should have blown him away. God! And the police.
Oh, they were great, too. But the gun down, scumbag. And then hot shot. Oh, God, that pissed me off. Maybe an asshole, but I'm not a scumbag.
Donald, get in the car.
You're right. I'm overreacting. Sorry. Oh, God.
Know something, Sonny? Really miss that gun.
I've had it with guns for one night, Donald.
Yeah. Boy. Can we stop and look here?
You don't know what guns look like?
We'll browse. Just a few minutes. We'll just check it out. Come on, please.
Oh.
All right. I'll go it alone.
Donald, that light changes. I'm leaving.
I'll take a cab.
If you're not out here in 10 minutes, I'll be gone.
Ah, bless you, Sonny.
Seven to ten feet.
I wouldn't go with this. It is going to happen. Society is going to bite the big one. And like West says, when the going gets tough, the tough get going. But the smart money's going to head for the hills.
Donald.
Number 62.
Sonny, can you wait just a minute? I want to see what happens when society bites the big one.
Magazines and periodicals throughout this.
Mister, can I see one of those magazines?
Well, sure, partner. That's what we sell. And you know your training fee can be applied for the down payment on a Wes Huntley Deluxe Survival Hideaway.
That's the 44 Magnum.
Can I hold it?
Oh, sure, I'll let you number.
Can I hold that one?
Oh, yeah.
Thanks.
This fits in the small of the back.
Oh, really?
You should come up behind someone.
Well,
Oh.
Come on, Donald, let's go.
It's I'm quite looking, a hefty son. Weapon for
oh,
a woman.
Look at that.
You got
I
it.
I can get used to it. I can get used to it.
Okay. Can I see one of those?
Oh, sure.
Thanks.
Let me check it out for you.
64.
There you go. Take
something. And Paul Ridge.
Thank you, pardon.
This obsession that people have for guns.
Yeah, just like the cowboys.
Uh-huh. How about that,
yeah.
Huh?
Aim it right down the barrel. It's sight right down the barrel, yeah.
Oh, boy. I like it. Can I get a shoulder holster
a
for
shoulder those? Holster? Sure.
Yeah.
They make a shoulder holster for it.
Yeah, how about right
it's,
in
it's gonna, it's
see how I got that, it. Huh? I pull that out
it's,
all right,
it's
didn't
quite
I?
Bulky. You sure you wouldn't want to go for something a little more compact?
That little thing wouldn't kill a flea.
Well,
I bet if you saw me with this, you'd run, wouldn't you?
I want one.
You don't want one?
Yes, I do.
No, you don't.
Oh, I have wonderful luck with my mace.
Well, so you think you'd like it?
Yes, I would, but I what's
maybe
that?
Maybe we could go together
on this?
Oh, well, thank you very much. But I'm allergic to mace.
No, I guess, no standards. Quite a weapon.
It's too bad.
Quite a weapon.
Just looking.